Hi everyone, this is Eric Scott and welcome to another Foodie Friday. Have you ever had one of those meals around a special occasion and whenever you have it again, it takes you right back to that moment? That's what I want to share with you today. On one of the very first cruises I took with Sandra, she ordered at a French restaurant, Coq Au Vin. And when we got back, she asked me, would you learn how to make this? And I did. I learned how to make it in a heavy cast iron Dutch oven. And every time I would make it, it would remind me of that moment in time when I sat across from this beautiful woman eating this delicious meal and thinking, one day I'm going to make this woman my wife. I've figured out over the years how to be able to do traditional French Coq Au Vin in a slow cooker, and that's what I'm going to show you how to do today. As always, we have Henry standing by, our sous chef. Everything that we make in this kitchen is sent to this lab for testing, and you know what? Henry is the best lab taster in the business. We wouldn't have anybody else assisting us in this kitchen. Traditional French Coq Au Vin made in your slow cooker. Let me show you how it's done. Now, before we begin, I want to talk to you a little bit about the wine that we're going to use in this dish. Coq Au Vin is traditionally made with a French Burgundy wine. It's very similar to a Pinot Noir. In fact, they're made from the same grapes. The difference is the location and the climate and the soil. And while I've made Coq Au Vin using a Pinot Noir in the past, the Burgundy wine really does make the difference. It adds a richness to the dish that just isn't present with a Pinot Noir. We're going to be using this 2016 Joseph Faivoli Burgundy. The price point on this wine is about $25, and that's on the high end of what you should pay for a Burgundy wine in this dish. You can find a very serviceable Burgundy wine in the price point of $15 to $20. This is not the dish to use your two-buck chuck on, even though I'm a big fan of cheap wine if you enjoy drinking it. Spend the extra couple of bucks on the bottle of wine. It truly will make the difference. Coq Au Vin is a chicken dish to be sure, but it's really the rich Burgundy wine and the vegetables and the spices that all combine in a reduction to give it its deep, complex flavor. So into the chicken, which I'll show you here in a minute, we're going to add 2 packages of baby Bella mushrooms that we've quartered, 2 cups of rough cut carrots, 2 medium shallots that we've quartered, 4 cloves of minced garlic, 2 bay leaves, and the spice that brings it all together are a couple of sprigs of fresh thyme. Also into that, we're going to add some bacon, about 9 to 10 strips, and it's okay if you use the pre-cooked bacon. It saves some time, it also aids with your cleanup, but it's still going to add to the flavor. We're also going to use pearl onions. These are traditional in the dish. Yes, you can use chopped yellow onions, but it's really the pearl onions that are traditional in Coq Au Vin. I'm using a package of frozen pearl onions. Again, easy, helps with the cleanup. The chicken, we've used 8 chicken thighs and 4 chicken legs, skin on, and I've chopped each one of them in half. So you can see what we have here with a chicken leg, and then with the chicken thighs, it's given us better serving portions. All of that will go into the dish. You're going to need some salt and pepper, some olive oil, and some flour. We're going to start by dredging our chicken pieces in flour and getting them ready to brown. It really is important with this dish that you get a really good sear and then a nice brown crispy skin on your chicken, because this is going to be in the crock pot for up to 8 to 10 hours. The longer the better, and you don't want to have chicken skin that is mushy or mealy. So take the time to be able to brown the chicken. We've brought our oil up to about 375 degrees. We have our chicken pieces that we've very lightly floured, and now we're just going to place them in the oil to get a nice, good fry and brown on that skin before we put them into the slow cooker. You can see how nicely our chicken pieces have browned up. The skin is nice and crispy, and that's going to make for a really great presentation and texture once this dish is finished. So how do we combine it all together? Well, we start by layering in some chicken, and then let's add into that some of our carrots, and then some of our mushrooms, and then just start adding in more of the chicken. Really, the secret to this dish being done well in a slow cooker is that you have everything nicely layered in there, so all those flavors have an opportunity to commingle. And then when you add in all of that broth, it's going to be just delicious. There's our shallots. We're going to add in a little bit of our garlic, 4 cloves in there, maybe a little bit more. How about some of our bacon? That got Henry's attention when he heard the word bacon. He knows that one very well. On the top of that, we're going to add a couple of bay leaves and then a couple of sprigs of fresh thyme, more or less to taste. But the thyme is also going to be one of the predominant flavors that you're going to have. The rest of our bacon. And now it's time to add 2 cups of chicken stock. And then a bottle of burgundy wine, less 1 glass, because you deserve a reward after all of that. This has been in our slow cooker for about 8.5 hours now. Let's take the top off and see what we have. Wow, that is absolutely fabulous. Look at how that chicken has cooked and is just literally falling off the bone. That is a fabulous, fabulous treat. All our big pieces of carrots and our onions and our bacon and our mushrooms. Let's plate some of this up. Get a couple of big pieces of the chicken in here. I want some really big pieces that we can kind of layer into that. And we want some of our carrots. Definitely some mushrooms. And don't be stingy with the broth. That's really what makes the dish. So there is your slow cooker Coq Au Vin. So here is our slow cooker Coq Au Vin. Boy, just the smell of this. I can't wait to taste it. And this is going to be fall off the bone delicious. The chicken and the mushrooms. That is truly fabulous. So rich. And the burgundy wine really is the key. Buy 2 bottles so that you can have one with it when you serve it for dinner. An amazing compliment to this dish. Oh, but before we serve it to anybody, we have to send it to the lab for tasting. Henry, come on up here. Henry loves our Foodie Fridays. He's been waiting again all day. It really is torture for him when we do a slow cooker meal because he has to wait for hours in order to taste it. All right, Henry, first you have to eat your vegetables. Let's try a little piece of carrot. What do you think? No, I think he likes that. And now, some of the chicken. What do you think? I think he likes it. Another lab-tasted, lab-approved meal from Henry, our official lab taster. Hey, follow me on Instagram at ericscott101 and on Facebook, Wine and Dine with Eric Scott. And that's where you can find details about my next amazing VIP Wine and Dine cruise leaving November 17th out of New Orleans. It's a 7-day cruise. You're going to be back before Thanksgiving. We'll be sailing around to Mexico, spending some time on a private island, tasting great food and wine. All of the details can be found at Wine and Dine with Eric Scott. Thanks very much for watching. Please keep cooking. Your family deserves it, and you'll make memories for a lifetime.